We've talked about adding vectors when the two of them are parallel, when they're anti-parallel, meaning pointing in opposite directions, and we've also done an example for adding two vectors when they're perpendicular to each other, which we can do using the Pythagorean theorem. The trouble is, a lot of times you get situations where they're at a really weird angle. And how are you going to add the two vectors together in that case? And the answer is embodied in the concept of the components of a vector. So we're going to introduce the components and then and show you how you can use components to add and subtract vectors in a very elegant way. So two concepts in this section. Let's define the multiplication of a vector by a scalar. Multiplying a vector A by a positive scalar M gives a vector that is in the same direction and its magnitude is M times A. So for example, got a vector A here, points a little bit up and to the right. Its magnitude is 4 meters. Great. What is 2A? Well, 2 is a scalar, just a number, and A is a vector. And I want to know the direction and the magnitude of this vector, 2A, which we call B. How do we find it? Well, according to this prescription, we multiply the vector A, that's this vector, by a positive scalar. In this case, that's 2. M is 2. And that gives a vector in the same direction, but with a magnitude, in this case, is 2 times the magnitude of A, which is 4 meters. So we should have a vector whose magnitude is 8 meters. And sure enough, this is what's shown here. That vector B is in the same direction as A. Its magnitude is twice the magnitude of A, 8 meters versus 4 meters. No big deal. All right, the second part. Multiplying a vector A by a negative scalar M. So now m is a negative number. M equals minus 2, for example. And that's what we will do for this particular example. Gives a vector in the opposite direction with a magnitude of the absolute value of that scalar times the magnitude of A. So how does that work? If I'm interested in this product, negative 2. So in this case, m is a negative 2. So it's a negative number, negative scalar. And I multiply A, then I'm going to get a vector in the opposite direction with a magnitude absolute value of m times A. Okay, I've got it definitely in the opposite direction. I did that right. And then I need to find the magnitude by taking the absolute value of m. M is minus 2. A, the magnitude of vector A, is 4 meters. The absolute value of negative 2 is just 2. And so we get the same magnitude for this case, still 8 meters, this one here, but it's in the opposite direction. Now this is relates back to when we talked about what the negative of a vector is. And I said that there was a little phrase in that concept where I talked about the fact that the magnitude is obtained by multiplying a vector by a negative 1. Here's where this is pertinent. If m equals a negative 1, then we have to follow this prescription that we get a vector of the same magnitude because we're multiplying by the absolute value of a negative 1. then we get a vector with the same magnitude, but opposite direction. And I ask you, what's a vector with the same magnitude and in the opposite direction? You say, the negative of the vector, and I say, yeah. Yeah, this is just the negative of the vector. Like we talked about a couple of concepts ago. All right, let's define unit vectors and use them to resolve a vector into its components. The unit vectors are denoted with a boldface letter, that X in boldface, not italic type, and it has a little caret symbol, a little hat over the top. That's an indicator that this is a unit vector. And these vectors point in the x, y, and z directions respectively. So if this is x, the x-axis, this is y, the y-axis, then x hat is a little vector that points in the direction of the plus x-axis, and y points in the plus y direction, and z points in the plus z hat, points in the plus z direction. So, and the reason we call these unit vectors is because they have magnitude 1. So they don't have any units. There are no units associated with unit vectors. Unit means 1 in this case, and by units that could have been confusing. By units, I mean they don't have any dimensions. They're not measured in meters or anything like that. They're unitless or dimensionless vectors, but they're called unit vectors because their magnitude is 1. So they have magnitude 1, point in the x, y, and z directions. Components ax, ay, and az are defined by this relationship. Okay. So what does this relationship tell us? I'm saying that the vector A can be resolved into three different components. One bit in the x direction, and the amount of that vector that's pointing in the x direction is called the x component of that vector, a sub x, a with a subscript x. So ax is the amount of the vector a pointing in the plus x direction. You say, well, hang on, how about this question? Suppose you have x and y, and A looks like that. Then how much of A is pointing in the plus x direction? And I say, none, it's pointing in the minus x direction. In this particular case, AX, that X component of A, will be negative. In this case, AX is positive because it's pointing in the plus X direction. So similarly with Y and Z, this is the piece of A that points in the Y direction. And if we add all of these three vectors, well, ax, x hat, plus ay, y hat, plus az, z hat, then we get the vector A back again. So an important point here is that This is nothing new. We know how to multiply a vector, this x hat, by a scalar. How do we do it? If the scalar is positive, the resultant vector points in the same direction. If it's negative, it points in the opposite direction. That's where we get this case here. We know how to add vectors. If we just think of this as a vector and add it to this vector, I have to put the tail of the second vector at the head of the first vector. Here's the second vector. Here's his tail. And I'm going to place it at the head of the first vector and then find the resultant vector here. With a similar thing happening with if we have a z component. We would add another vector, in the z direction to get the final vector a. So it's just, it's nothing new, just a way of characterizing a vector. But this gives us another way of writing vectors. Instead of writing a vector as its magnitude and its direction, we now can characterize a vector by its three components in the x, y, and z directions. And in many cases, for two-dimensional problems, we don't even need to worry about the z component. Most of the problems we'll deal with don't have that z component. They'd just be x and y. So these are two equivalent ways of writing a vector. This is called the magnitude and direction form, and this is called the component form. Both completely specify the vector. All right, vector has magnitude 5 meters, points at an angle of 50 degrees, measured counterclockwise from the x-axis. I want 50 degrees, that's about like that. Has a magnitude of 5 meters. There's my vector. Here's the y-axis, plus y-axis, plus x, plus y. This is minus x, and that's minus y. All right, find the components of this vector. Well, that looks like a big pain. Well, maybe not. Let's draw a line down here and find the piece of this vector in the x direction and call that a sub x. And the piece of this vector that's in the y direction and call that a sub y. I guess we're calling this vector a. So now, can we find those two pieces? The answer is, yeah, we're smart. We can do this. Look at this. This is just a right triangle now. There's a right angle. And I know this angle is 50 degrees. And I can relate this side of the triangle, AX, to the hypotenuse using a trigonometric function. This is the side adjacent to the angle 50. And so what trigonometric function do we need? And you say cosine. Cosine of 50 degrees is the side adjacent over the hypotenuse. Now in this case, the hypotenuse is this 5 meters here. We already have the hypotenuse. It's the magnitude of the vector. So now I can solve for AX. 5 meters. Notice I'm carrying along the units. Cosine 50 degrees. So you can plug in the numbers and find cosine of 50 multiplied by 5. This is going to be something less than 5. What about AY? You say, well, I'm getting the hang of this. I can do AY. I want to relate this side of the triangle and this hypotenuse of the triangle to this angle 50 degrees. So what trigonometric function would we like to look at? You say the sine. I say you're exactly right. Sine of 50 degrees is the side opposite this angle. Here's the angle. Here's the side opposite. and therefore find AY is 5 meters times sine 50 degrees, which gives whatever it gives. So those are, that's how to find these components from the magnitude and direction. You can also do it the other way. If you knew AX and AY and you wanted to find the magnitude of the vector, how would you do it? You say, I think I can use the Pythagorean theorem, can I? And I say, yes, you can. Because this hypotenuse squared equals this side squared plus this side squared. And that's how to find the magnitude. How to find the angle is, if you didn't know the angle but you did know these two sides, then you can take the tangent of that angle equals AY over AX, take the inverse tangent to find the answer.